Hello, hello, hello. Today is September 28, 2021. I will probably post this solution to problem 120 5 days from now. Maybe 4 or 5. This is the problem. These are the values that were given. I close this switch at time t equals 0. I record at very high time resolutions of a fraction of a millisecond the values of V2 and V1. At a particular moment in time, I measure that V2 is plus 2.360 volts. And the question is, what is V1? I go around this closed loop and I calculate the integral, the closed loop integral of E dot dl. Since there is no change in magnetic field in this direction through this loop, there is no self-inductor in this loop, Faraday's law says that the closed loop integral of E dot dl is zero. Some people call that Kirchhoff loop rule. Well, Kirchhoff loop rule is only a special case of Faraday's law. Faraday's law always holds. So I start here and I go around and come back here. So that closed loop integral of E dot dl must be zero. I go through here, that is plus V2. If this voltmeter had had its plus here and its minus there, then it would have been plus V1. But I can reverse the voltmeter at my will. Then the current inside the voltmeter will go through the coil in the opposite direction. Therefore, it will record, if the current is in this direction, it will record minus V1. When I reach the battery, I go through the battery, the E field in the battery is in this direction, so that is minus V equals zero. So V1 is minus 9.640 volts. More than 50% of the answers claim that it is plus 9.640 volts. That's wrong. Now, is it deadly wrong? No, because you got the right idea, but you slipped up on the sign. It is minus 9.640 volts. The time, I didn't ask you to calculate the time, the time that this happens is 1.626 milliseconds after t equals zero. If you want to brush up on LR circuits, watch my lecture 802, lecture number 20. What you can see, though, very easily, is the situation at T0 and the situation, say, 5 times L over R. L over R is called the time constant of this circuit. L over R is 1 milliseconds. Yes, the units of L over R are really seconds. Let's first go to T equals 0. At T equals 0, there is no current flowing through this circuit because the self-inductor prevents that from happening. So if there is no current going through R, clearly V1 must be zero. But if I now go through this circuit, no current flowing through here, then you see that V2 must be the same as V, because the sum of this voltage and this one must be zero. And so V2 is then plus 12 volts, the same as this one. Now we wait 5 time constants, 5 times L over R, that is almost infinitely late. So now the self-inductor is powerless. LDIDT has really become zero. In other words, the full current, which is V over R, which is 1.2 amperes, flows through this self-inductor, There is no internal resistance in here. So clearly V2 will indicate 0 volts. There is no potential difference between here and here. The current flows through this R, 1.2 amperes, so V1 must then be 12 volts if this were plus and this were minus, but since this is minus and this is plus, V1 will be minus 12 volts. I put here a sketch, not to scale, of the voltage that you measure versus time. This point here would be roughly L over R, which is 1 millisecond. V2 starts at plus 12 volt at T equals zeros and goes down with time constant L over R. And when it reaches 5 times L over R, clearly V2 is zero. V1 is negative. So I should have plotted V1 down there, but I ran out of paper. So I plotted it here, and I put here a minus sign. So the fact that it reached 12 volts here, V1 is then minus 12 volts. So the current the voltage increases from zero to gradually minus 12 volt, and it stays there forever and ever and ever, as long as this battery is alive. So all the current goes then through the self-inductor, and it goes through the resistor R. Potential difference between here and here is plus 12 volts, between here and here is minus 12 volts. Okay then, if all this is new for you, then I would suggest you watch lecture number 20 of 802. It is a simple problem. And of course, the reason why I introduced a self-inductor here is in a way to test you. Because that self-inductor doesn't play an important role other than that it prevents the current from going immediately to 1.2 amperes. So that's why the V2 is here only plus 2.36, and why the V1 is still not minus 12. But this closed circuit is still zero at all moments in time. Faraday's law, Kirchhoff loop rule. Okay, have a nice day and take care. And if you cannot do this, that is irrelevant to being friends. We'll always be friends. That's a given. That has nothing to do with your knowledge of physics. But my objective is that even a simple problem like this teaches many of you some physics.